Good evening and welcome everyone. My name is Sudarshan Seshadri. Joining me here today is my colleague Robbie Espinosa and Cliff Siegel, Executive Vice President from Lifetime Brands. The topic for today's breakout session is serve your customers better with AWS Supply Chain. Today you'll hear about AWS Supply Chain, how it helps you respond better and more quickly to demand volatility and supply disruptions with comprehensive inventory visibility, AI-driven trends and risk insights, and ML-powered lead time predictions and demand planning capabilities. Cliff will talk about his experience leveraging our demand planning capabilities. Supply chains are central to everyday life, getting us products we need when we need them. However, even in the best of times, getting products to the right place at the right time is challenging. And for supply chains, these are not the best of times, as we know. Over the last few years, we've seen a wave of supply chain disruptions, from the COVID-19 pandemic to geopolitical issues and increased inflation, on top of the usual disruptions we've had to deal with, which include weather-related disruptions, labor disputes, transportation and supply constraints. So from cream cheese to cars to computer chips, these disruptions have been widespread. The universal truth of supply chains, as we know, is many companies lack timely end-to-end visibility into their supply chain and visibility to potential disruptions. And the main cause of this is because data is spread across a vast network of planning and execution systems, and in some cases, they reside outside the enterprise. Scattered data coupled with point solutions makes it very difficult to stitch all this data together in time to take timely decisions and drive corrective actions through your supply chain. So what is needed? How do you put your supply chain data to work? Companies need a modern supply chain application that's purpose-built, that enables them to take vast amounts of data so that they can make better and informed and timely decisions, respond faster to disruptions, capitalize on opportunities, and get from data to insights and really take decisions on time to be able to quickly detect, predict, pivot, and provide solutions to problems before they occur. So by treating data really as an asset, generating insights, and making it available to key personas in your supply chain and help them make better informed decisions has become more than a competitive edge for our customers. So we are happy to announce AWS Supply Chain, as you might have seen in the keynote yesterday, a new cloud-based application, purpose-built, full-stack, cloud-native application, leveraging over two decades of Amazon.com's supply chain innovation and the power of our AWS stack from compute to storage to machine learning, bringing it all together to help you build resilient supply chains. So that'll help you enable faster decisions, drive cost savings in your supply chain, and more importantly, drive better customer experiences. So by leveraging the power of our cloud and cloud-native architecture, this out-of-box supply chain application that we've launched this week helps you handle the volatility and the complex problems that supply chains face today. And there are four critical components of the AWS supply chain application. It all starts with data. So the first fundamental component is a supply chain data lake that's purpose-built that helps you aggregate data from disparate applications, enterprise applications, ERP, planning applications, execution applications in your enterprise, and from your suppliers and from your network, pulling all this data and building an extensive canonical data model that's sitting on top of this data lake. Now, once we get the data, our data association layer helps us ingest this data from disparate systems, and using our out-of-box connectors and pre-trained NLP-based machine learning algorithms helps us build this harmonized data model in our supply chain application. Now, once we have data, the intelligence layer then kicks in, tries to connect demand, supply, inventory, shipment information, all of this together to provide you actionable insights, help identify risks, potential disruptions that you can anticipate in your supply chain, right? And then provide you the ability to take corrective actions and collaborate with the right stakeholders to drive timely decisions through your supply chain. And all these insights are surfaced to business users through a persona-centric user interface that allows them to prioritize these disruptions surface those insights based on time to impact, severity of impact, collaborate with other stakeholders, like I mentioned, and drive corrective actions, which could mean, you know, rebalancing stock across locations, expediting shipments, substituting products if needed, shipping from alternate locations, all these kind of corrective actions that you typically take within lead time. And now I want to pass over the baton to my colleague, Robbie, who's going to give us a quick demo, a short demo of some of the key capabilities of what we've launched. Robbie, all yes.
Thank you, Sudarshan. So let's take a little closer look at the product. AWS Supply Chain Insights is going to give you, first of all, enterprise inventory visibility. As Sudarshan pointed out, we're going to aggregate the data from your disparate systems and consolidate it into a harmonized data lake for supply chain specific. Then, once we have the data, we're going to go ahead and generate insights. Those insights are going to be inventory risk alerts or lead time deviations. But now that you've generated the insights, what are you going to do? Well, the solution gives you sustainability-aware stock rebalancing recommendations, and these recommendations are meant for you to go ahead and resolve the insights. After the recommendations, lastly, you're going to go through and actually execute on that. You're going to execute through a series of notifications, as well as collaboration with the other collaborators inside of your organization to go through the whole resolution process. Let's dive deeper into the application. Imagine that you are an inventory manager and you're responsible for a region. In this case, you're responsible for the United States. Lots of sites and facilities within the United States. Some of them could be distribution centers, others could be manufacturing sites, or maybe small fulfillment centers. As we displayed in this one single view, you get to see your enterprise visibility, and we aggregate the data in easy-to-read format. For example, you see a cluster down in Southern California, which is the bottom right-hand side of the square. You see 13. That means it's a cluster of 13 sites there. But every site is displayed there, and you see a circle around it, and that gives you the health of that site or that cluster of sites. You also see a bar on the bottom right-hand side. That bar is a timeline bar, right? Because we don't necessarily want to give you that an insight and an inventory risk that you're out of stock today, right? It's already old news that happened, right? So this bar allows you to move forward in time, days or weeks, and we use projected inventory views to go ahead and tell you that there's a potential risk down the road, right? It's not about just now, we want to go down the road. So that bar there allows you to move forward in time and see those potential risks. Now, going back to the circle and the health, you see the three different colors. The red, obviously not good. The red is meant to give you a potential inventory risk. So there's a risk that your inventory levels, based on the time and date that you're at, they'll be at or below your minimum safety stock. The purple indicates that there's an excess of inventory, and the green is the good zone, that you are above your minimum, below your maximum. As we go through, we can actually drill down into one of these sites, and we see this information specific for this one location. Not only do we see our on-hand balance, we can see whether I have allocated inventory, whether there's something in transit or not, but on the bottom, you see the graph, and that's the projected inventory view. So this is what we calculate, this is what we project out where you will be in the future, and what our algorithms determine whether there'll be an inventory risk or not. As we go through a different view, not only can you see that information in map view, you can also see it in your typical grid view, and it could be sorted by either location or by site. So you can see all the products in one site that you manage, or you can see all the locations that may manage a particular product. Now, this is a lot of information, a lot of data. Do you want the user to go through there? Well, what the application does is we have a series of watch lists. What the watch lists allow you to do is to set a series of parameters where the AWS supply chain solution can go ahead and monitor your inventory positions based on those criteria and generate the insights, right? So it'll automatically monitor the projected inventory, see where you're going to be based on demand, expected receipts, and generate those insights. Now, those insights Once they get created, they're going to get sent to different users, right? So you can determine who's going to get those alerts, who's going to get those notifications, so they can start addressing those. These insights are displayed to the user in an agile slash Kanban style set of cards, and this help you organize and prioritize your work. On your rightmost side, you see all your new insights, all the new things that have popped up, everything that's been generated. The middle section is the one that's in flight. What you're working on right now, it's in review. You're collaborating with your teammates. You're trying to get those resolutions. And further on the right, you see everything that you've already finished and resolved. As we take a look into these cards, pay attention to little squares where that indicate that there's collaboration going. So as you try to resolve these issues, you're going to have to work with the rest of your team. You can go through here, start the chat. And this stays contextualized within that insight. So instead of having to search through emails, through countless threads, countless groups, you can see it all within the insight of this one insight, this one incident. As you look further into the insight, the solution gives you a set of recommendations as to how to resolve this. In this case, how to resolve an inventory risk. So you're going to run out of inventory. How can I solve this? The solution gives you a set of recommendations and says where you can fulfill it from. And each one of those recommendations comes with a score. The score has three levers, and these three levers are going to be managed by each company, and you'll be able to set the score to specifically match your company's goals. And these are the three levers. The first one that we take into consideration for the score is the distance. How far away are the two sites that can fulfill the supply and the one that needs it? The second lever is the inventory risk resolved. So not only can I provide the amount of inventory that's required to resolve the risk, but am I gonna put at risk the site that is providing the inventory? So it may be closer, but I'm gonna put the site at risk. So maybe that might not give me the best score. So we take that into consideration. And lastly, for those of you that may have sustainability as a key initiative in your organization, AWS Supply Chain will go ahead and give you an estimate of the amount of CO2 impact that completing that recommendation will cost. So as you go ahead and set your tolerance for each one of those three levers, we'll calculate a different score. And that score will be displayed, and that'll help you make the best choice as to how to resolve that inventory insight. Lastly, AWS Supply Chain provides, with machine learning, a way to predict the lead time based on all the purchase orders, shipping history, product attributes, vendors, and locations that you were shipping. And it gives you a recommendation as to what your lead time should be compared to what you have defined. As you go through your purchasing plan and your replenishment plans, you typically look at your lead time, and you take that into a factor to determine when product's going to arrive and how much you need to buy. However, if that value is incorrect, you may not be making your best purchasing decisions. So as the machine learning algorithm comes up, it'll make a recommendation as to what you need to be setting that lead time in order to make better purchasing decisions. It'll also show you the impact that it's going to have on potential in-transit purchase orders. So anything that's already in flight, it'll list what's there, and it'll show you a potential estimated deviation for each one of those. Also with the solution, we have AWS Supply Chain Demand Planning. This is a module that uses machine learning algorithms to generate a highly accurate demand forecast, and it removes the guesswork out of forecasting, and it really allows your demand planners and all the team to go ahead and view, manage, and collaborate on the forecast. This will help the team generate a consensus for the demand plans. And now, I'm going to present Cliff Siegel, EVP of Lifetime Brands, and he'll talk about his experience with the demand planning solution.
Right. Thank you. Good. All right. So thank you, Robbie. Everyone, thank you for sticking around for a late session. My name is Cliff Siegel. I'm the Executive Vice President of Global Supply Chain for Lifetime Brands. And for those of you who don't know Lifetime Brands, we're a leading provider of kitchenware, tableware, other products that are used primarily in the home, consumer good products. And we sell them at a lot of different brand names. And I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with these brand names, Farberware, KitchenAid, Mikasa, Sabatier, Swell, many other different brands that we're selling. And we have a global focus, and our multi-channel access to customers motivates us to continually look for ways to increase our forecast accuracy so that we can better position our supply in anticipation of our orders that are going to be coming in from our customers. And in order to keep up with our growing business needs, we were already looking for a robust machine-powered demand planning solution that would allow us to plan across multiple dimensions and perform quick what-if scenario planning. And with Amazon Demand Planning, we're able to iterate, test, and generate sell-through forecasts for numerous subsets of our data. And only a short period of time, we were able to take our data and bring it into Amazon Demand Planning with minimal effort. And we began running the data in Amazon Demand Planning parallel with our existing demand planning system. And then what we found from Amazon Demand Planning and using it is that first, it was a much easier tool compared to our existing demand planning system just to use it. But we also found a significant increase in the forecast accuracy of our baseline forecast. So comparing the two forecasts side by side, we immediately saw benefits from using the Amazon Demand Planning. And we anticipate that we'll be able to save multiple days in our process by reducing the time necessary to review the forecast, because now we're starting with a better baseline forecast, making it easier for the planning team to review and have less exceptions that they're going to have to deal with in that process. So we're looking at partnering with AWS to continue to integrate Amazon Demand Planning into our ecosystem and working to arrive at a consensus demand plan more rapidly and use that to drive our supply planning process. So thank you. I'm going to pass it back.
Thank you. Yeah. Should I be? Thank you. Thanks, Cliff.
So, in summary, what AWS Supply Chain allows you to do is really to focus on solving your supply chain challenges right now. Right? So as we go through and we allow you to really free up your enterprise data that resides in different silos, it harmonizes them into a single supply chain data lake. What this allows you to do, really, is to embrace your current investments that you've already made on ERP and other supply chain solutions, right? So this will augment those investments for you. Also, this provides immediate insights. Once the data is harmonized, you get those insights immediately, and this will help you fine-tune your supply chain, make it more resilient, and allow you to be more proactive versus reactive as you experience disruptions. This will help you mitigate risks, and this will also help you capitalize on opportunities so that you can adjust your supply chain as things and conditions change. All of this innovation is really available in the purpose-built capabilities of the AWS Supply Chain product, and this provides a single location for you to innovate your supply chain. And again, this is just the start of our journey. We really can't wait to see where the future holds and really help you, the customers, bring the supply chain, solve the supply chain problems of the future. Thank you.